life endures, that amazing grace of God will be with us. Good morning, everyone. Thanks for coming today, once again, to remember our brothers who died 21 years ago, but also to join again together in prayer so that we remember who we are. We remember our brothers who died, but we also remember who we are, loved children of God. We are here to do a holy thing, to pray. But we're also here to do another holy thing, to remember. To bring to our minds and hearts our 343 brothers who sacrificed themselves 24 years ago today, and also the 275 we lost since then. And we are to bring all the guys who are here with us from the battalion. Fire guys from another house, family members. Bring them here right now. Because we used to pray for them and remember them. So you bring them here right now. Your mind and your heart. Make them members of this group. That's what it is to remember. And in doing this, maybe you realize how much room there is, not just here in this church, but how much room there is in your own heart, and how deep your heart really is. Gather together in God's heart and pray in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace of peace part for Jesus Christ, the love of God, our Father in heaven, and the joy and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
We bring the best of ourselves right now. We remember the things that separate us from God, one another, the goodness of life. For all that does separate us that way, we ask for God's mercy. Because of illness related to working at the fire. Lord, let time never lessen the impact of this day. May we always remember our brothers, their courage, their goodness, their strong spirit, their sacrifice. Protect all who know in harm's way to save others, especially in the fire department of New York. Watch over those who continue to struggle with physical illness and heartbreak that traces back to this day 21 years ago. And protect all who work to protect our nation. We especially ask that you strengthen our faith and trust in you and comfort us with your promise of eternal life. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and who reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Please be seated. We'll listen to the word of God now. Our first reading will be done by Chris Campbell.
Reading from the book of Sirach. My son, if you come forward to serve the Lord, prepare yourself for an obedience. Let your heart right and be steadfast, and do not be alarmed when disaster comes. Pray to the Lord, and do not leave, so that you may be honored in the end of your life. Whatever happens to you, accept it. Be patient in changes of life that humble you. Since gold is tested in the fire, and chosen men are tested in the fire of humiliation. Trust in the Lord, and he will hold. Make your way straight and hope in the Lord. You who fear the Lord, wait for his mercy. Do not turn aside lest you fall. You who fear the Lord, trust in him, and your reward will not fail. You who fear the Lord, hope for good things, for everlasting happiness and mercy. The word of the Lord.